And welcome back for some more White March Part 2. I'm the RPG Chick. You may notice at the last video, or at the end of the last video, it was daytime out. Now it's nighttime. That's because between videos I said, wait, we gotta rest up. We're screwed up with our battle from those bleak walkers. They were pretty tough. It was the bleak oath quest that we finished last episode. Pretty interesting, but it looks like that boy's going to be hunting down Kern, although that we haven't seen any result from that yet. Don't know if we will. I figured we should better get back here and help him, and well, there's nobody here, so the boy isn't there. And I wouldn't blame him, because he has a, you know, his parents were killed. I'd kill the guy too. Or, well, try to. Anyway, we're headed to First Fire's Crucible Keep right now to help Masca. Is it all Iron and Flame? Alright, Iron and Flame. Bless the Hammer at the Shrine of Abaddon. We will attempt to do so. First Fire's. Crucible Keep. Here we come. Still love the music in this game. So well done. Sets the mood perfectly. We are here. The Shrine of Abaddon can be found at the rear of the keep. Alright, let's take a scenic walk around. Let's talk to Justiciar Aldmar, why not? He might have something new to say. Looking for something? Or just knocking the dirt off your boots? Nothing new. So I'm really glad to be finishing this game, even though I love it so much. Forge. That was there before, right? Location discovered archives? Wait. This is the archives? Why is it telling me location discovered? We've been here already. We've gotten all the goods, that's what this is white stuff means. Yeah. So, hail. Torment Tides of Numenera is coming out. A couple months. You guys excited for that? Anyone looking forward to that? I sure am. It's bound to be in some ways similar to this, in other ways completely different. Now, was that... That might have been Abbott... See, now we're rediscovering everything. I mean, free XP, I guess. We just walk around this place, get all the XP. Take something out? Oh, we have that book. No new books, huh? Battle axe. So yeah, really looking forward to the new Torment game coming out. So the vision she had on top of the West Tower of what's the name of the place again? Jurgen's Battery? That might have been Abaddon himself. And now we're going to a Forge of Abaddon, so I'm kind of wondering if there's any connection here. We shall see. The Shrine of Abaddon lies before you, smelling of metal and oil. Bless Masca's Forge Hammer. You place Masca's forge hammer at the base of the shrine. For a moment, nothing happens. Then you hear the distant ring of hammers striking anvils. Tens, then hundreds, then thousands, all in unison. Masca's forge hammer suddenly flares with light, and the chorus of hammering fades away. You retrieve the hammer, and though its appearance hasn't changed, it feels heavier somehow. We got to level up. Nice. Travel to Magrin's Fork and locate the Shrine of Magrin at the crossroads. Complete the second part of the ritual by blessing Masca's forge hammer at the shrine. Okay. Either I didn't know or I forgot that there was a second part of the ritual. How many rituals are there? Okay. We can all level up. How about... After the sixth rank, the previously earned bonuses become more powerful in the same order they were received. So... We'll get a received healing multiplier. Or I could take... Lore. Athletics, I can't go no higher, so survival. We've got new reaping knives. The cipher uses an ally's soul to create blades of pure energy that emerge from both hands. The blades do raw damage and generate focus for the cipher who created them. Cool. Gives a little back, huh? Reaping knives, summon weapon reaping knives for 40.5 seconds. So this is what it summons. It's a universal dagger. 15 to 20 raw damage. Okay, and we've got we can take both. Okay, we got defensive mind web. By linking his or her mind with those of nearby allies, the caster creates a series of defensive links between them. All allies in the mind web use the best defense of anyone in the web. That's pretty sweet. Kind of like a buff, right? Alright, well, we can take both, so we're going to take both. One down. Survival. Increase bonus damage versus flanked enemies. Or... Athletics. I guess survival? I'm not sure. Oh wait, can he take more? Sure. Catabald's Black Bow. Summons a frightful bow that does crow's damage to enemies and leave them terrified. Terrified for 4 seconds. Foe jump targets. Okay, only jumps to foes. I like that. So we can take two. Kalakoth's Freezing Rake. I fail to see, like, frost-based attacks in the White March, I'm thinking, is going to often be not so useful. Do the damage we wanted to do. A ghostly skeletal hand rakes across the area, doing freeze damage to enemies in the area, leaving them weakened and humbled. Hmm. 73 to 91 freeze damage. But I wouldn't surprise if a lot of these enemies just have a bonus against that. Langrath's Superior Elemental Bulwark. The wizard is protected by elemental shields that guard him against burn, crows, freeze, and shock damage until they are overwhelmed or the duration expires. 100 point burn damage shield. Freeze, shock, corrode. Huh? Major Grimoire Imprint allows the wizard to temporarily borrow druid, priest, or wizard spells of 7th level or lower. For the short duration, the wizard can cast the stolen spells freely. Or steal a spell from a foe. Steals 3 spells of level 7 or lower for 78 seconds. That's pretty interesting. Hmm. Minoletta's Piercing Sigil. The wizard invokes the sigil of the famed Valian wizard Minoletta. Hopefully we don't have to fight that wizard at the end of this DLC. When he or she is struck in melee, the sigil retaliates with pierce damage, pushing the target back and leaving them stunned. That's pretty sweet. Wall of Many Colors. Summons a scintillating wall of varied colors that inflicts various damage and afflictions on enemies passing through it. That's neat. Okay, so all the colors have exclamation points at the end of them. Red is burn, orange is corrode, yellow is shock, green is raw damage, blue is petrified, indigo is dominated, and violet is paralyzed. I like that. It's pretty neat. Wilting Wind. A parching wind blows across the battlefield, inflicting raw damage on anyone in the area, leaving them weakened. Of course, it's going to attack friends as well, so how about not that? How about Wall of Many Colors and I'll try the Freezing Rake. I can take another level 5. I was confused too. Confused. Behave normally, attack an ally, walk in a random direction, or do nothing. Area of effect. Only affects. That's pretty cool. I like that. We'll take confusion. I'll take confusion for 200 Alistair back. Athletics. Or let's take survival. I kind of like survival. All this increased goodies. Vigorous defense. Armored grace. I'm not taking any more new war weapon specializations. Confident aim. Discipline barrage. Guardian stance. Defending allies. That's pretty good. Take the hit. Sundering blow. The fighter makes a primary attack that does additional damage and lowers the target's base damage reduction. That's cool. Don't we already have charge? Triggered immunity. Immune to slash damage for 15 seconds. Overbearing guard. Fearless. How about Sundering Blow? Endurance. I'll take more stealth for him. A lot more stealth. You know what? Hold on. Take another survival. 4 is accuracy. I don't remember his stealth being so low like that. Alright, we got more another spell we can take here. Barring Death's Door. I should use this. If I haven't been using it already. Shining Beacon. Restore Major. Shining Beacon. Pelagina. Inspiring Triumph. Liberating Exhortation. You're not gonna read all this, the effects. Zealous Charge. Deprive the Unworthy. Aegis of Loyalty. Reinforcing Exhortation. Zealous Endurance. Hastening. Healing Chain. Sacred Immolation. Ooh. The paladin focuses his or her faith and self-immolates in blue flame. Each time the ability pulses, the paladin takes a small amount of raw damage, but enemies in the area take burn damage. Allies receive a small amount of endurance. One per encounter. Self-target. And a little over 4 meters radius from the caster. Lasts 39 seconds. Take raw damage. 6. AoE, 22 to 34 burn damage, and allied plus 11 endurance. Huh. Interesting. Abjuration. Destroy any spirit or summon creature below the paladin's level. The thing is, how will I know what's below her level? Behold the Martyr. The paladin targets a fallen ally, creating a pulsing beacon over them that increases the speed and damage reduction of nearby allies while decreasing the speed and damage reduction of nearby enemies. The beacon disappears if the ally is revived. If the paladin is knocked out in battle, this ability is automatically applied to him or her. I'm gonna try the immolation one. That's for when she's doing well in battle and other people might not be doing so well. Okay, finally our resident barbarian. No survival. Bonus to damage when endurance is below 50%. Hold on, guys. Brute force. On attacks that normally target deflection, the barbarian will instead attack fortitude if it's the lower defense. That's neat. Wild sprint. Threatening presence. As long as the barbarian is stationary, nearby enemies may be sickened. All you need to do is stay there and fight and people get sickened around you. Accuracy versus will. That's pretty cool. Which sickened means that you... All attributes reduced by 1. Fortitude and will reduced by 10. That's nice. So far I'm leaning towards that. Bloodlust. When you personally down at least 2 enemies. That's not going to happen very often. Vengeful defeat. Have to be reduced to 0 endurance. Causing instant carnage full attacks on anyone in range. Eye of the Storm. The barbarian cannot be engaged by enemies that are more than 1 level lower than him or her. It does not prevent the barbarian from being attacked in melee. Dragon Leap. Ooh. Drawing upon reserves of intense spiritual power, barbarians are able to leap high into the air and crash down upon their foes, dazing them. 1 per encounter. Foe AoE, 26 to 39 crest damage. Very small radius, but still. Dazed for 17 seconds. Immune to engagement for 2.3 seconds. I like that one too. Echoing Shout. That's like another shout that causes crush damage as well. And Bloodthirst. After killing an enemy, the barbarian's recovery is waived, allowing them to attack again immediately. Passive. I'm going to do Dragon Leap. I'd actually love to see that in action. And we're done with that. This is a symbol of Abaddon, a colossal smithing hammer imposed over a circular gear. It's smooth and bright with buffing oils. Alright. Now if we go up here, we'll discover this. Thank you. And if we go in here, we'll discover this. I guess that's something that can't be discovered. Stomp, 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 stomp. Barracks? But the forge here. Forge. Yeah, that's it. Discovered all the stuff. Now, where did it say to go? Magrin's Fork? Magrin's Fork, yeah. At the crossroads. Where's the thing here? Over here somewhere, right? We also have to go to Searing Falls. Oh, all the way back up here. One of the starting zones. Crossroads. Here? Shrine of Magmin. I know stuff is respawned here, but we'll find out if we run into something. Oh, there's something there.
See now what the flame has shown us?
Cool. Scroll of Nature's Mark. 2 bloodstone. The ash-covered Shrine of Magmin stands before you, the scent of charred wood still lingering in the air. Place Masca's forge hammer on the shrine. Oh, we're gonna fight something. The temperature around you... See, if we had Magmin, I guess we could stop it, maybe? The temperature around you begins to rise, and before long you feel as if you are standing in front of an open forge. Masca's hammer begins to glow red hot. Suddenly, the ground near the shrine erupts into columns of living fire, flame blights. In the sky, oh boy, winged shapes dive towards you, smoke trailing from their wide open jaws. Fight! We got drakes. Yep, there it be. The page on turn added. Blind Monk's Venom, minor item. A series of murders has shocked and terrorized the scribes of White Rock Isle. Sequestered in their island monastery in the Boot of Andra, they have had little success reaching out to the mainland for help. Though renowned for their integrity and artistic talents, the scribes may be unknowingly harboring someone who is attempting to sabotage their work on forbidden books. Let's assign that to the grieving mother, I believe it is. Right. Okay, we're surrounded by these blights. Cool. Good theme. That kind of boss theme, isn't it? Alright, first of all, Holy Radiance. Who's this? Adair. Well, Adair, just head right for the frickin' drake. Let's try to keep the drake busy. I should remember to use that sometimes. Summon the skeletons. Unfortunately, Aloth's gonna get it, isn't he? Knockdown already activated. I forgot to turn that on. Let's see if we can get our spell off. How about this chaotic orb thing? How about this freezing rake? Oh, that activated quickly. finish off this. Can you get both of them like that?
Hey.
Knocked down.
Hey.
Immune, huh? We're just like beating the crap out of him. Well, that was so easy.